Hey guys, welcome back to Let's Play Donkey Kong 64. You guys may be wondering why I am outside of the second level, Angry Aztec. Yeah, that's what the level's called. Well, it turns out I need a certain ability in order to move on. I could have gotten it. Actually, I should just swim out there. Just as a point of reference. I need a certain ability from Cranky. But right now, I just want to travel to the island of where we will be going in a little bit. Sure to activate warp number 5. And let's make our way into Jungle Japes. Alright, first things first, we need to get Tiny Kong's necessities. We need her gun. We need her unique moves. I would also say we need her instrument, but that's in the second level. So yeah. Alright, where to first? Well, first off, let's go get Tiny Kong's blueprint, because it's not far from here. See where the purple coins are? That is our purple blueprint. Oh, I remember. And it just occurred to me. I think I remembered his name. This guy. His name is Chris Flat. Because if you stand far enough away from him, he will actually say his name, Chris Flat. Nope. Yeah, he won't hurt you unless he finishes the combo. So there is still a chance that you won't get hit. Alright, first off, we need Tiny Kong's gun. Let's go to our main man, Funky, and get the gun. We get the feather bow. Now the feather row, it's interesting at the very least. Like, it doesn't shoot completely straight, it just like wafts around. Kinda like that. It still shoots straight, but it just doesn't, it just doesn't stay completely straight. It is a little more realistic. What do I need? I need Tiny Kong. There we go. And let's go back, because I need Tiny Kong's potion moves. I need her barrel move. And looky here, we got more coins. And I'm pretty sure there's nothing else here. Whee! Alright, let's pay a visit to Old Man Cranky and see what he has for us. That's a pretty unpredictable potion if it shrinks your hair and your body, but not your head. I was hoping to get the next move. I like the next move she gets. And anyone who's played this game or knows Dixie Kong, they will know what move I am talking about. Thanks for giving me a banana, by the way. Thanks for giving me 15 of them. Thankfully, Tiny Kong's switch isn't that hard. But of course, they give you less time. But with the warp, this is incredibly easy. Okay, there we go. Let's see. There are two more bananas I know of off the top of my head. I have to remember that third one. I've kind of forgotten the third one. In this area, we will need to come back with Lanky as well. But in here, we have a bonus barrel. I did not put away my gun, apparently. A pretty straightforward one. It's just hard because it's underwater. Basically, just collect the star coins in the middle first. And then go for the ones on the bottom. There's 5 in the middle of the barrel and 5 on the bottom of the barrel. Well, there should be. Oh, never mind. 4 on the middle, 6 on the bottom. 1's in the middle. Thank you, random announcer guy. As Tiny Kong is sticking her head into the barrel. Alright, now for banana number 3. I guess since I'm not doing anything right now, I'm just traveling to the next barrel, or not barrel, to the next area, I will actually ask you guys the question. In Donkey Kong Country 3, there is actually an option where you can input your G-codes. First part of the question, how do you activate the G-code input? How do you activate the menu so that you can input your cheat codes? And for one extra point, what are all the cheats? Like, what are the name of the cheats and what do they do in the game? And Squash is just telling us that we can cancel our move by pressing Z and C left. And this is actually our first time being Tiny. Everything looks a lot bigger, so the enemies will no doubt be larger. There we go. Wish you could move faster. Hooray, ammunition. I love me some ammunition. Oh, banana coins in the corner. There we go, jeez. Nearly wasted all my orange grenades. Those will be the last switch you have to hit. Now it's just a clear run to the golden banana. Why am I collecting these? I'm pretty sure that's the only way you can get up there. You can't jump normally, so you have to do the backflip. I don't think there's anything else here, so we can just leave. Ooh, I just remembered where the fourth banana was. Hopefully we can get to it before the video ends, but first we need to do some banana collecting. Because as you can probably see, these logs have bananas in them. Yeah, they all have 15 bananas in them each. There's two logs in here, so be sure to not unshrink yourself before you go through the second one. And here we have our banana medal. Pretty sure, yeah, no balloons here. And was there a bunch of bananas for Tiny up here? Nope, that's for Lanky though. It's all for Lanky, all for Lanky. I think the fourth banana is in here. I get the feeling it isn't though. Nope. It's here somewhere, I know it. Come on. You have like 2 minutes left in this video. Supposedly 2 minutes. I went over the limit on the last one, but I still like to try to keep it as short as possible. Like, if at all possible, I don't want to keep you guys here too long. I'm pretty sure you guys have all have lives to live. You don't want to spend like 30 minutes watching me play a video game and trying to figure out where the fourth banana is. Where is it? I am utterly confused. I'm totally confused. Come on, something. It's gotta be here somewhere. I'm probably missing something incredibly simple. Because I'm pretty sure, yeah, I have only 3 bananas, but I have the blueprint. There's an area I'm not checking out. But sadly, that will have to wait until next time, because I am out of time. So, I'll see you guys next time on Let's Play Donkey Kong 64.